listen to, but I promise I'm not gonna. What time? How much do I have of my senior? 10. All right. 10 more. Here's the second lesson, and I'm gonna bang the podium as I say this. Don't dumb down the faith. Don't dumb down the faith. Yes. Pounding had the desired effect. Good. You know, I, as a kid, was a Catholic kid going to Mass on Sundays, but what got me on fire, and the fire's never gone out to this moment, was a class when I was a freshman at Fenwick High School outside Chicago, and a young Dominican friar came in and taught us the five arguments from Thomas Aquinas for God's existence. And I to this day, I say, grace God, and I don't know exactly why it happened, but it lit a fire in me of fascination. And I believed in God, of course, but it gave me a sense of the reality of God that's never left me and that set me on the path I'm still on to this day. I'm standing in front of you because of that class. I can say that without fear of contradiction. You know, I love the teacher, Father Tom Paulson, taught me that year, and then I went to actually another high school the next year, and I never saw him again. Until last fall, I was in St. Louis at the Aquinas Institute, and one of the young Dominican friars comes in. I said, hey, you know, it's because of people like you that I became a priest. And I told the story, and he goes, oh, that was Tom Paulson, wasn't it? I said, yeah. He goes, he's in St. Louis. He is? He was right down the street from where I was speaking. I said, could you please have him come? And over he came, and now he's in his mid-70s somewhere, I think. But I was able to pose with him and get a picture of him. But that's how I started, was through the intellectual life. And I know that's not for everybody, it's not everyone's path. But it was the beauty of the church's truth that grabbed me. Now, I'll fast forward to when I started doing evangelization. I can't tell you how many people said to me at different times, hey, dumb it down, you know, it's too smart what you're doing there. And too many long words and Thomas Aquinas, and it's not going to work. You know, you got to tell little stories, you got to be real experiential. Thank God I didn't listen to those people. And you know, because you know what bugs me, as you probably can tell, is the way we patronize our own young people. I first read Romeo and Juliet when I was 14. I was a freshman in high school. That same year. Well, did I understand it? Of course, I understood 10% of it. But so what? Because to this day, I've got this deep affection for Shakespeare. What struck me when I read Romeo and Juliet was that such a thing should exist. Just fill me with wonder. That there should be such a thing. It's like hearing Beethoven's Ninth Symphony for the first time. It's like the Sistine Ceiling for the first time. It's like seeing Sharp for the first time. That there should be such things. It's the great Catholic intellectual tradition. We're a beautiful religion, yes, and we are a smart religion. Newman said, a sign of the corruption of Christianity is when it stops thinking seriously about the faith. Amen. We're a church that, at our best, has never stopped thinking about the faith. I want the students here, I know they get it here, Aquinas, and Augustine, and Origen, and Chrysostom, and Jerome, and Bonaventure, and Anselm, and Thomas Aquinas, and Ignatius of Loyola, and John Henry Newman, and G.K. Chesterton. I want an immersion in these people. And don't tell me that kids, or high school kids, or college kids can't do it. They're reading Einstein in science. They're reading Virgil's Aeneid in Latin class. They're reading Hamlet in English class. And we're giving them pamphlets in religion. Does that bother you? It bothered me for years, and the new evangelization has got to be a smart enterprise, or it's not going to be successful.